क्या आपके फेमिनिज्म में इंटरसेक्शनैलिटी है? That's right, intersectionality. Feminism is supposed to be about equality for everybody. But historically, it seems to have fought for only the most privileged amongst the oppressed. So we know feminism is flawed, but it's also evolving. How? Partly thanks to intersectionality. What is intersectionality? Let's find out. Before we begin, we know. We too come from a place of privilege, but we'll do our best to keep it in check. Let's try to figure this out together. If feminism was a highway, you'd think it looks like this, but what it actually looks like is this. Each of these intersections has its own unique set of problems. Sometimes these overlap, creating a whole new set of problems. It's not the addition, but the multiplication of oppressions. As women, every part of our identity comes with its own problems, apart from gender. And we thought we'd let the women with these different identities speak for themselves. So let's explore some of them. Religion.
Take the example of a Muslim woman seeking alimony in a case of triple talaq. She could face multiple injustices on account of being a woman and also a religious minority, which is a completely different kind of oppression. This is exactly what happened in the landmark Shahbano case, which stood at the intersection of religion and gender.
Caste.
Dalit women are usually discriminated against in our country. Their oppression is so widespread that a 2018 UN report found their life expectancy to be 14.6 years, less than that of higher caste women, due to lack of access and support. Even though India's Me Too movement was a great stepping stone, it failed to give Dalit women a voice as it was led mostly by upper caste and upper class women. Meanwhile, Dalit student Raya Sarkar's attempt to out harass us in academia, Losha, was largely ignored.
Sexuality.
While Section 377 may have been struck down, attitudes toward the queer community are as dated as casual misogyny in 90s Bollywood. In our heteronormative culture, a queer woman has to face discrimination based on her gender as well as her sexuality. Additionally, regressive policies like 2018's ironically named Trans Person Protection of Rights Bill offer no actual protection to the community.
Ability.
Missing. The dialogue around the differently able women in our country. Urban women with disabilities have 9% lower literacy levels than their male counterparts. Differently able people are in a vicious circle of lack of education, low employability, and poor economic status. And women with disabilities suffer even more, courtesy sexism. It's an experience that can only be lived to be understood, which is why it's critical for us to start this conversation.
So how can I be an intersectional feminist? First, take a step back and check your privilege. It can be uncomfortable to confront our biases, but comfort never won us any revolutions, did it? Next, educate yourselves. Read about the history of oppression and listen to those who lack your privilege. Lastly, help amplify the voices of the oppressed without speaking over them or focusing on your narrative alone. Feminism is supposed to be inclusive and it's high time we make that a reality. Let's listen and learn. Remember, it can't be feminism without intersectionality. Tell us your thoughts on intersectional feminism in the comments below. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Vitamins 3.